Welcome to the Sacramento State Piano Series. I'm Richard Chanko, Professor of Piano at Sacramento State. I'm also the coordinator for keyboard studies and the director of the Piano Series. The series is an important part of the Keyboard Studies program at Sacramento State in that it offers the students many opportunities to see world-class pianists right here at their own school. Having just celebrated its 20th season, the series continues to bring 4 to 5 piano recitals per year. Great pianists such as John Nakamatsu, Jeremy Denk, Eduardus Halim, Abby Simon, Leslie Howard, Nelita True are among those who have visited. Let's look at a photo montage of past artists. John Nakamatsu, winner of the Van Cliburn International Piano Competition, visited us recently for his 3rd performance on the piano series. Let's watch him as he performs an excerpt.
Thank you.
In 2011, the music world celebrated the 200th anniversary of Franz Liszt's birth. I took the opportunity to invite two very great pianists, Adam Niemann and Edwardus Halim, each to perform the complete Transcendental Etudes of Liszt. These pieces are amazingly difficult and very exciting to hear. The cycle lasts about 70 minutes long. Let's listen to Adam Niemann play the beginning of Faux Follets, Etude number 5, with elegance and grace and an amazing lightness of touch. Here's an opportunity for the students to sharpen their comparative listening skills. Let's watch Edwardus Halim perform the same piece, yet quite differently. This is Faux Follets again, Etude number 5, played with, yes, elegance and grace and a lightness of touch. But you'll notice that it sounds a bit different from Adam Niemann. During the 2013-2014 season, the series engaged pianist Natsuki Fukasawa. Here she is performing one of the most difficult works for the piano. It's Leopold Godowsky's Symphonic Metamorphosis on Themes of Künstlerleben by Johann Strauss, Jr. Here is an excerpt. Also in 2013, the series engaged pianist Jeremy Denk. Jeremy Denk performed a wonderful recital that included the Bartok Sonata, a Bach Prelude and Fugue, several Liszt pieces, and he ended his program with Beethoven's Sonata Opus 111, the last sonata that Beethoven wrote for the piano. But I would like to focus in on the Dante Sonata of Liszt. Let's hear Jeremy Denk performing the opening of the Dante Sonata with great drama and pure conviction. Thank you. Now let's listen to Jeremy Denk play a complete performance of the Liebestod of Richard Wagner in the piano transcription by Franz Liszt. Behind the scenes here at Capistrano Hall, where all the concerts take place, we are fortunate to have a full-time piano technician by the name of Mr. Ted Kidwell. His daily tunings and his concert preps are crucial in the life of this department, and in particular to the piano series. Here he is at work. Do you hear that? Do you hear that?
Very helpful. That's what we're going to be talking about today, is how does the artist and the concert technician communicate about sound and touch? It's not as simple as it might seem because we have so few words to do with sound. What do we say? We say a sound is bright, we say a sound is dark, we say a sound is loud or soft, but we don't really have nuanced words for sound. So when I'm working with an artist who has a very refined idea and concept of how they want to present their art, I need to understand as quickly as possible what it is that they're telling me that they need. So you're hearing a little action click, a little something. You're crazy. Okay, let me see what I can do about that. One of the challenges of tuning a piano is that you can't tune it perfectly. It's just mathematically impossible to make every key on the piano perfectly in tune. You could make C major in tune, but then C sharp major would be very out of tune. So we do what's called tempering. We put a temperament on the piano. A synonym for temperament would be compromise. We make, in equal temperament, we make every key on the piano equally out of tune so that you can play. All of that equally out of tune. Now, of course, there are hundreds of other temperaments which are not equal temperaments. They favor one key over the other. And in fact, this piano is tuned in an unequal temperament. So C major sounds more consonant than B major. The advantage of that tuning system is that as the composer goes to different keys, you're going to have a different color to that key. And of course, the disadvantage is that it's going to be more out of tune in those keys. The other aspect of tuning that's difficult is you can't tune straight octaves. The octaves must be stretched. So as you go up, these octaves are slightly wider than a natural octave, such that the piano increases in frequency toward the treble and stretches down toward the bass. And that gives a fuller, richer sound to the piano. If it's not stretched, it sounds very compressed and smaller. So when you tune a piano, you are changing the tensions of all of the individual strings by turning the tuning pins. Now, a piano only has 88 notes, but you can see I've got very many more tuning pins than that. The average piano has about 240 tuning pins, and that's because most of the notes have three strings. So a lot of what I'm doing is to tune the unisons. I need to tune all three of those strings so that they ring at exactly the same pitch. So, for example, I'll take this note in the middle. That's three strings ringing now. But if one of them doesn't sound, is not exactly right, you get this sound. You can see it takes a fair amount of finesse to get it right back in the right place. A lot of very subtle movements to get it to go into the right place and to stay in the right place. Next time you see a concert pianist playing very heavily on a piano, think about all of those little tuning pins and strings and how they have to remain perfectly in tune under all of that stress. Not bad. So what engages the strings to cause them to start to vibrate, of course, is the piano hammer. And the piano hammer is controlled by the artist via the key. And what all of that assembly collectively is called is the action, which slides right out of a piano. And you can see you have this fairly complicated system of levers. Which allow a pianist to perform Beethoven, Chopin, Mozart. I have here a working action model of one note of a grand piano. So you can see that there are quite a few parts down in here which conspire in a very somewhat complicated way to give the response that a pianist needs to be able to control and perform an amazing piece on a piano. In a way it's complicated, but in a way it's a simple concept because it's a system of levers. You have a lever that's on your side of the equation, and then you have all this business that you're lifting with your effort. And if you straightened out all of these zigzagging levers, you'd have a simple lever, which was about 5 to 1. This long arm being 5 times this one. So you're on the one side. And in order to get the hammer to strike in an appropriate place in the string, it's been compressed and shortened using all these zigzags. So a lot of what I do when I'm rebuilding or redesigning a piano action is I can change these levers in a variety of ways. When I'm preparing for a concert artist to use one of my pianos, of course I do my best to prepare the piano in a way that I think will be pleasing to them. But sometimes they will find some aspects of the piano that they want changed. They might even find a problem that I hadn't noticed. That's when it's time for me to come into performance mode, because I often have very little amount of time to understand what it is that they're trying to tell me and to correct it to their satisfaction.
Each of our artists on the series gains valuable access time to Ted Kidwell before their recital. The result is always a beautiful experience. Recently, we had the opportunity to engage pianist Dmitri Rachmaninoff for a second performance on the series. This time, he played an all Scriabin program, which included 4 of the sonatas, several etudes, and several preludes. Let's listen to Dmitri Rachmaninoff perform a Scriabin prelude and a Scriabin etude. Let's watch again while Natsuki Fukasawa performs a work by Rachmaninoff entitled Do Not Sing My Beauty.
Thank you.
Now let's watch her performing a work by Granados called Danza Lenta. I would like to extend an invitation for you all to attend the piano series at Sacramento State in its 21st season. All concerts take place on Saturday night at 7:30, and you can search for our webpage online for current information. This 21st season promises to be stellar. We have pianists Faina Lushtak, James De Leon, Tanya Gabrielian, Augustin Anievis, and Kirill Gliadkovsky, all coming to perform. Take a look. Thank you. I hope to see you all there at the 21st season of the piano series at Sacramento State.